Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner. Today's story is a critical iOS patch and Apple patch day. Yesterday was Apple patch day, and they released updates for a lot of their software. Pretty much updates for all of their operating systems. If I remember right, this now includes tvOS, watchOS, iOS, or their mobile platform, and OS 10. But they also released updates for Safari, their browser, and for some Windows applications, specifically the Windows version of iTunes and the Windows version of iCloud. Now, these updates fix a ton of vulnerabilities. If you look at the OS 10 and the iOS vulnerabilities, there's just a laundry list of CVE, or vulnerability numbers, that are fixed. A lot of them are arbitrary code execution flaws. So if a bad guy can maybe get you to interact with a media file, that can result in executing code on your Mac, or in some cases, remote code execution as well. Now, the biggest vulnerability is related to one I talked about a few months ago in a video. Back in April, I had a video about an emergency iOS patch that fixed a problem in the Broadcom Wi-Fi chipset. This chipset had a vulnerability that attackers could remotely leverage to execute code on really many platforms that use this chipset, not just iOS devices, but Androids and other wireless devices that might use this Broadcom chipset. By the way, this vulnerability has been largely coined BroadPwn because it affects this Broadcom chipset. In any case, back in April, they fixed a vulnerability related to this Broadcom issue, but apparently another researcher has reported some issues with the Broadcom chipset, and this update fixes this vulnerability as well. Now, this is a critical issue in iOS devices. I mean, really, all an attacker has to have is wireless range to your device, and they could theoretically pwn any iPhone out there today. Now, this researcher hasn't released any technical details yet to the public, but he's actually one of the speakers at the Black Hat Conference, which we're attending next week. So for the curious, we might have more technical details about it in a CISSP blog post. But the long and short of it is, if you have a mobile device that uses iOS, it's pretty critical that you get 10.3.3, which has this update and many others. But really, the moral of this particular news is, if you have any Apple products, like any of their operating systems, their browser, or even if you're a Microsoft user that has iTunes or iCloud, go get these updates as soon as possible. The good news is most Apple products are set to automatically inform you of updates, so it's just a matter of letting those updates happen. Anyways, that's it for today's news. Thanks for watching.